All I hear is raindrops falling on the rooftop. Oh baby, tell me why'd you have to go? Cause this pain I feel it won't go away. And today I'm officially missing you.
Darcy!
I hadn't even pressed record yet, and I already got makeup on my white shirt.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
I'm actually getting ready to go somewhere today. I'm not just like putting on makeup for the camera and then like taking it off immediately. I'm actually for realsies leaving my apartment today. Wow. But lately these get ready with me's have been like me actually talking to you guys about stuff and not just like putting on my makeup and not talking about stuff. So I'm on my way to an event held by a Korean brand. I thought I would just talk to you guys about how I've been feeling lately. Get into some emotions. So first things first, obviously gotta put on my VDL primer. You know what's awesome? I'm seeing so many beauty gurus who aren't into K-beauty use the VDL primer. Love it. I love this primer because it's so moisturizing and glowy. Like, look at the way it makes my skin glow. And for foundation, I'm doing my normal mix. My face has actually gotten a little bit darker because it has been sunny lately, so I've been going out for walks with my dog. I am a little bit darker, but I'm still going to mix these two together. I'm pretty sure this is still gonna be a little bit too dark. So this is the VDL Perfect Lasting Foundation. I don't know why I said it like that. Perfect Lasting Foundation in A06. And then this is the All Day Luminous Foundation from NARS in Macau. Usually I take like two or three pumps of this and then one pump of this because I'm just trying to make it a little lighter. Honestly, this was such a weird year. And the year's not over yet or anything. So far, this has been such a weird year. I've never had anything remotely dramatic happen to me in real life, but on the internet, I've been involved in so much drama. And honestly, I'm still really confused as to why these people even care about me. But I guess I'm confused because I've gone so long with basically being invisible, and now thousands, sometimes even millions of people are watching me, and it still just hasn't really sunk in yet. Like, to me, I'm just a normal person, and normal people get to have opinions about things with relatively little to no consequences. For example, if I was a normal person, I could have a fight with someone, and only me and that person and like a couple of our friends maybe would actually care about it. But now if I have a fight with someone, I get flooded with DMs from strangers telling me to effing die. And I'm not saying I'm famous or anything because that's not even remotely true. But I feel like I'm in this weird place where I don't have complete anonymity anymore. So I'm not entirely just an everyday person. But I'm not famous either. It's just like this weird in-between place. Oh my god, I love this combo! So I feel like I'm just trying to navigate this weird place that I'm in. A place that I put myself in, so I'm not really complaining. But it is what it is. It's a place nonetheless. I can't say that I'm not here just because I put myself here on purpose. Like, before I got a little bit more popular, I used to comment all the time on other people's YouTube videos. Like, I watch YouTube all the time. I watch YouTube all day sometimes. And I used to comment on other people's videos a lot. Nothing ever mean or offensive, I would never do that, but I would just, you know, make a joke here and there, comment on whatever was going on in the video. But now I don't comment on YouTube videos as much as I did before. And when I do, I always stop and think to myself, like, is this okay for me to say? Will saying this damage my image? And it's always good to censor yourself because you don't want to be saying crazy stuff anyway. But it's also kind of sad because it's like, before I say something, I'm always thinking, can someone use this against me? And I don't read my own comments anymore either because honestly, they're really traumatizing. And I laugh about it now, but when you're sitting there reading all of the horrible things that people are saying about you, it's not fun. I'll read comments usually the first day, maybe like after I upload a video, and then after that, I'm not trying to expose myself to that kind of abuse, so But I used to read all of my comments. I feel like people with small channels usually do, because, you know, there's not that many, so you can easily keep up with them. But as you get bigger, you literally won't be able to keep up with all the comments. But like, if you sit there and like refresh and watch the comments come in, then you're gonna catch all of them or most of them. But I don't do that anymore. Because when you have a smaller channel, almost all of your comments are positive. When you start getting bigger, especially like if you have a video that like goes viral or something, then you get people who have never seen you before, or people who are not really interested in your content but they just clicked on the video because it looked interesting. So those kind of comments, those are the ones that I'm trying to avoid. I used to have zero blocked words on my channel. Like, I didn't even know that that was a thing, that you could block words on your channel, but it is a thing in case you didn't know. YouTubers actually have the option to block whatever words they think are inappropriate or that they don't want on their channel from the comment section. If someone makes a comment with one of the words that I've blocked, that comment doesn't make it to the actual comment section. It goes into like a special kind of spam folder. So I would have to go into that folder and approve things manually. And when I tell you guys, there are thousands of comments in that folder. Sometimes there are people who are using blocked words, but like not in a negative way. Those comments still go into the folder. But you know, I'm not gonna go into the folder just to find the few comments that are nice in a sea of comments that are derogatory and disgusting. Let me give myself a quick spray. The other day, I woke up to a comment on my Instagram that said,
"You shouldn't accuse someone of blackface when you've clearly lightened your skin."
And I'm like, I've never lightened my skin. But like, why bother arguing? So I just block and delete. And it's so funny because the person that they were defending has publicly lightened her skin in a vlog. People literally straight up make up lies about me. You just have to stay in the strong resolve of, I know who I am and that's what matters. And it's really difficult because no matter what anyone says, everybody cares what other people think about them. Everyone cares. The key is not to stop caring, but to just keep being yourself anyway. But you'll always care, and that's what's really difficult. You just need to not let the caring get in the way. I'm using contour almost as blush today, so it's gonna be like a lot. Don't be alarmed. It's not a mistake. I know what I'm doing, kind of. I've seen entire long posts about me that are straight up lies. I saw a lie that I can speak fluent Korean. Like, first of all, why would I pretend that I can't speak Korean? That makes no sense. Like, it's some kind of cover up, some massive government secret. Like, I can secretly speak Korean, but I'm hiding it for some reason. Like, that makes no sense. And now there's literally thousands of people who think that. Thousands of people who think straight up lies about me. Not like, oh, half truths, misunderstandings. No, like, a lie. And there's no point defending yourself because there are people out there who want to hate you. They dislike their lives so much that they enjoy hating you, that they make a pretty much a sport out of it. So getting someone like that to not hate you is impossible. It's just something that you have to accept. It's so funny to me, like, I wonder what my high school self would think of this newfound popularity, because I was not popular in high school. Just to paint a picture for you, I was in the anime club and I watched The Golden Girls as a 14-year-old. I'm a Dorothy, but I kind of wish I was a Blanche. But anyways, that's enough excitement for me. I'm just trying to live a quiet life these days. But it's funny because it's always the so-called controversial videos that get me the most subscribers. I personally don't think that my content is controversial in the slightest. Why is it controversial to try Korean makeup if you're black? I don't get it. And I say black specifically because it's always my race and my skin color that people go after. And I don't see white bloggers or the Asian bloggers who aren't Korean getting the same kind of pushback that I get. But the second I tell my viewers not to buy something because it's not opaque enough or the color isn't right, then suddenly I need to stay in my lane. And their favorite thing to do is to tell me to try Fenty. As if my dry ass skin could handle matte Fenty foundation in a Canadian winter. Only people who know nothing about makeup say stuff like that. I get people telling me to use regular makeup all the time. Last time I checked, pretty sure Korean makeup was regular makeup. It's sold in my country, at my mall, within walking distance of my neighborhood that's full of black people. And there's no instructions on the package that say, only for Koreans. Like, this isn't the American segregation era. There's no blacks allowed sign on the cosmetics. Ugh. I'm grabbing my Too Faced Just Peachy palette and I'm using this color right here, this one that I hit pan on like 8 years ago, but I'm still digging into it, girl. It's still there. It's still, don't judge me, okay? This is the color Peach Cobbler and it's the best color in the palette. Obviously, I want to do like a brown smoky eye kind of, you know, so I'm using this as like a base and then we're gonna go in with the brown. Gonna be a little bit of a sexy mamacita today, girl. Okay. Guys, don't forget to remind me to do my eyebrows because half the time I forget. Anyways, sometimes I feel like I'm being put through this because I'm like an innovator. A visionary? I know that sounds so dumb. What am I trying to say? What I mean is, like, I'm one of the few darker skinned people out there that's doing something that traditionally darker skinned people aren't supposed to do. I'm trying something different on purpose and that makes it controversial. Like, it's literally makeup. Like, it's makeup. And y'all starting a federal investigation about it. Like, are you okay? It's makeup. It's makeup. Nobody's dying. This is not a life or death situation. Like, it's just crazy to me that me just trying makeup and different makeup styles is controversial to people. Like, people are losing their minds. When I was a kid, I was a competitive dancer and the foundation shades were never dark enough for me. So I would always look super ashy in my photos. And I don't think it was until I got to high school, like middle of high school, before I started noticing that companies were making shades that were dark enough for me. I started wearing like powder foundations, but I was almost always the darkest shade, which is so crazy because I'm nowhere near the darkest shade of human. Like, I wouldn't even really call myself dark skinned, maybe in the summer. I'm what most people would call brown skin. Like, I'm not light skin, but I'm not dark skin. I'm like in the middle. And now there are not just one, it's not just Fenty, everybody, okay? Not just one brand, but there are multiple that have shades of foundation that are 10 or more shades darker than me. And that's because people with dark skin showed companies that we buy cosmetics too and that there is a market for us. That's why the shades keep expanding. The consumers set the standard. It's not the brand that sets the standard. The brand has to do whatever the consumers want. Because if the consumers aren't happy, then they're not gonna buy the product. So the consumers set the standard. The companies have to step up to the standard or they'll fall behind to the competition. Like, recently Etude House has been using what looks like a mixed race model on their Instagram. And I don't wanna say it's because of me. It's because of us. It's because of you watching this channel. It's because of you buying Korean cosmetics. It's because of you buying Korean cosmetics internationally, overseas. You are showing that there is a market for darker skinned people. Every time I will literally go on the Instagram pages of Korean brands that operate internationally, and when they release like a foundation or a concealer range and it's not enough, people will comment on it and they read those comments and they take that into account for the next launch. People are showing that there is a market for darker skinned people even in an unexpected place that is K-beauty. And personally, I think that is so freaking cool. You guys are so cool. You know, I always get messages saying that I inspire people. Honestly, it's the other way around. You guys inspire me. I never knew that all of this existed until I started this channel. In real life, I'm the only person that I know really that's like into all the same things that I'm into. I grew up thinking that I was weird and that I was the only one who liked these things, and now I see that I was wrong and I found all of these people, and all of these people are sending me messages saying that they're so happy that I started my channel and that I've given them the confidence to be themselves and the confidence to try different things, and they don't feel ashamed anymore. And like, it gets me every time, because I literally didn't know any of you people existed. I kind of created this space by accident, honestly. Like, I didn't go into this thinking like, oh, I'm gonna create a space for dark-skinned people in K-beauty or something. Like, just that sentence is like weird. But I never intended to do that. I just started making videos about things that I liked, trying things that I wanted to try, and just being myself. And then people came onto my channel and they were like, oh my god, I love these things too. And I'm like, really? Because I thought it was just me. I thought it was just a nutcase. Like, but apparently not. Apparently there's a whole market now that Korean brands are actually expanding their foundation lines because of this new wave, this new market that they've discovered. I'm just gonna put on some brown liner. This is the liquid liner from Clio. It's the Kill Brown Liner. I don't usually wear eyeliner, honestly, but I'm trying to make a good impression today. Like I said, this weird little Canadian girl is going to an event today and I am meeting with a Korean brand. So I'm trying to look at least a little presentable. Thank you for reminding me to do my eyebrows. I'm going to be taking this brand new Brow Wiz fresh out the package. If it'll come out the package, please. But anyways, this whole conversation came about in my head because I was just thinking about the newfound responsibility that I feel like I have now. Before, I was just like this channel that no one watched and I could just say whatever I wanted and goof off and like do whatever, but now I feel like I have some sort of personal responsibility to people. And you know, you may say like, oh, you know, you don't really, because I don't actually. Yeah, like obviously I have no responsibility over other people besides me. I'm the only person that I actually have responsibility over, but at the same time, there's still consequences to everything and there's still consequences to the things you say. And I don't want to be responsible for hurting other people. You know what I mean? Like, I personally don't want to feel like I'm hurting other people by the things that I do or the things that I say. And I also have to realize that even though you guys feel like my best friends, I have to remind myself that I don't know everybody that I'm talking to on the internet, and that it's not the same thing as talking to a best friend, because sometimes you get so comfortable in front of the camera that it's like, oh, I can say anything to you. But in reality, anyone on earth could be watching this video. It's not just me gabbing with you, my fans, like, you know, because you guys know what I mean and you know what I'm talking about and you know my personality and how I am, but there's new people discovering me every day, and those people are gonna misunderstand things that you guys wouldn't misunderstand. Do you get what I'm saying? Because like, talking to your best friend about something is not the same thing as talking to a stranger. Like, you wouldn't talk to a stranger the same way, because a stranger wouldn't understand you and the way that you say things and your perspective on life the way that your best friend would. Keep that in mind if you're a content creator. You have to keep that in mind that like, you can't just like run your mouth, because people who don't know you aren't gonna know that you're joking, or people who don't know you are gonna think that you're just like mean or hateful. So I've been trying to be more mindful of that, because you don't know me personally, so I can't really be offended if you have a certain idea about me because of something I said or did. And then last but not least, I'm using Cherry Moon from Sephora Collection. That's right, I'm not using a 3CE lip. Who am I? I have lost myself. So yeah, those are basically my thoughts about my channel and what's been going on lately in the past few months. And I mean, it is what it is. This is where I am right now. This is my YouTube journey. This is my own spiritual path. I'm just kidding. I really think that literally whatever you're going through, whatever's going on in your life, it's all a learning experience and everything's gonna be fine and it's not a big deal. It's not as big of a deal as you're probably making it out to be. You'll always come out on the other side. I believe in you. Those are my inspirational words of the day. Anyways, guys, I have to go impress this brand. So I will see you guys in the next one. Don't forget to give this one a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because I know you want to see more of this. So look at her. Damn. I did it. I will see you in the next one. I love ya so.